I get asked a lot if the way that I combine like femininity with engineering is like branded or intentional. I am me, Xyla Foxlin, and I am building the things that Xyla Foxlin wants to build. Anyway, let's start. I am trying to use my platform on the internet to like share how creative and interesting and artistic science and engineering can really be. I think my favorite part about being a content creator is that, unlike in a traditional engineering job where I would spend like 3 years designing the fin angle on one rocket, I get to prototype something and build it all at once and then move on to the next thing. And so I'm constantly learning, I'm constantly excited by my work because it's always new. The internet lets you create whatever job that you want. You have to be willing to put yourself out there, and it's like not for everyone, but the tools are at all of our disposal to forge your own path. If I had to put a label on my channel, it's like a random girl fucking around and finding out.
That's pretty good! Ah! Oh my god, wait. Can we start there?
Darcy. Okay, I was born in Boston, Massachusetts. I was not actually a very good student. And so I got involved in a ton of extracurricular activities. I was on the track team, I did theater, I did like everything else. I joined my high school robotics team as a secret from my friends and also on a whim. There was another woman on the team and she was one of the captains, but she didn't build a whole lot, even though I know she was capable. Like, she went to MIT. I think that there was probably some bias happening, but as a result, I also didn't really build anything. I was like quiet and obedient and I did whatever was told to me. And so I organized a lot of bake sales and I raised a lot of money, but I did not build on the robot. And that sucked. And then I became a captain my junior year and I was embarrassed to admit that I wasn't really working on the robot. I knew how to use tools because I was super active on the technical theater side of like school productions. And it was just this social fear, I think, of inserting myself in this, like, we never had any women work on the robot. I was pretty sure I was not gonna be an engineer. Like, oh, I'm probably unqualified. And the reality is I just never had had the opportunity to find out. I am not entirely sure when I decided I was gonna be a pilot, but definitely once the decision was made, it was very, very made. The summer between my junior and senior year, I got a job working as a line crewman at an airport. And it was perfect because I got to work in exchange for flight hours. But that was also what saved my engineering career. I had had this experience at an airport where it was very clearly lots of instances of pure sexism, where like I'd show up to fuel this guy's plane and he'd be like, no fucking way, a chick is touching my airplane. And you can look at a situation like that and be like, oh, it is so clear that that is just sexism. It's not that I don't have the skills, because I never even got the chance to show you the skills. And then I started looking at all these other parts of my life and realizing like, oh, I never got to build anything on my high school robotics team, not because I don't have the skills, but it's because like people just assumed I couldn't because of the way I looked. In college, I was like, I'm gonna be the best engineer I can possibly be. I joined the robotics team, I joined the rocket team, I was like going to hackathons on weekends, I was like building robots for this NASA robotic mining competition, and I learned a ton that year. There was this notion that I couldn't be super feminine and also be an engineer at the same time. And I was like, screw all of you, I'm just gonna go compete at Miss Ohio and see what happens. I will say one of the other reasons I did it is I wanted an excuse to build a musical Tesla coil. I read through the Miss America talent rules and fire is not allowed. And although fire is a plasma, not all plasma is technically fire. And so I figured showing up with like a lightning machine was not technically outside of the rules of Miss America. So I did this like musical lightning show And it was also part of the personal mission I had that was tied to the nonprofit that I had founded of like trying to get girls who are more feminine to know that they could do stuff like engineering.
Hey, I'm Zyla.
And I'm Andrew.
And we are the team behind Beauty and the Bolt. So congratulations, you're here.
It was really born out of an issue I saw with the makerspace that I worked at in school, where as the makerspace grew, we had less and less time as people who worked there to like sit down and help people with their projects. As a result, the people who were using the machines got less and less diverse. So I reached out to one of my friends and was like, how do you feel about making video tutorials for their space? Because I think that if someone had a video to watch on how to do it, it would lower the barrier to entry. So we made a handful of videos. A ton of schools and other makerspaces started using them as their training, and then it sort of like snowballed into a nonprofit from there. Making videos for Beauty and the Bolt was my first steps into YouTube and video creation, and especially being the one on camera. And with the nonprofit, I felt a lot of pressure to keep my project simple and like classroom friendly. And as a result, each project was getting less and less creative.
Hey everyone, welcome to my new channel. Thank you so much for being here on day one.
When I started my own channel, it was suddenly like, I want to be able to build whatever wacky, crazy idea that I can come up with. I want to be able to push myself really hard and like make projects that I don't even think I know how to do. So this is the project that kicked off my channel. What's funny is that I had every intention of launching my channel with the Cedar Strip canoe build, which is like a very take me serious kind of build. It's a Cedar Strip canoe from scratch. And then I finished this and I got excited and I posted a picture on Twitter and it went super viral. Turns out the answer is always weird art. I'd like to think that by using the platform that I have, that I'm at least changing people's minds a little bit, especially subconsciously, about who an engineer is and what they may look like.